We live in a world where it's absolutely acceptable and hot for girls to experiment with other girls, you know, even if they identify as straight and they may have, you know, a lesbian experience. And then, and that's like, oh, that one time in college, and they can like tell their, you know, the other moms in their mommy and me group, you know, 20 years later, and everybody laughs about it. Like, oh, that's so hot. How amazing is that? But if a guy does that, it's a totally different story. And straight men, I have found, are so terrified of being labeled as any, as being anything but like really, really straight. You know, I mean, even like dressing a certain way is like gay, you know, and there's just, there's such like, a fear.
Does this look gay, bro?
Right. There's such a fear with men and like their masculinity and how they feel, you know, and how they appear sexually. So, and I've always wondered, not being a man myself, if like maybe every man has a fantasy about another man every once in a while, but like, you know, they would never, like almost no straight man would ever admit that if that was true. So that's why I was just so curious about your story.
It's hard to say. And I believe there's probably like actually 100% straight people out there, because I know quite a few 100% gay people who are like, they were born through a C-section. They have never touched a vagina in their whole life. And they just was not. And when you mention licking a vagina to them, they throw up in their mouth. They're like, and like, that's 100%, right? So if there's that, there's got to be 100% straight, right? I don't know. I'm making this up, but I would think. But I have noticed that like real, the term like real men, like really, like I do some training for as a hobby, like gun stuff. And when I'm training with guys who are like ex-Navy SEALs or the Green Beret, you know, Delta Force, those guys, they do not give a fuck about gay stuff or not. And, you know, I mean, I have a little rainbow flag I put on my gun belt. And every now and then one of them will be like, oh yeah, my captain in the SEAL, he was gay. That's cool, bro. You know, or whatever. You know, they're like, oh, cool, whatever. You know, they just don't, no, they're not threatened. You know what I mean? By any of that. Some of them are so manly. They're like, oh yeah, I'm such a man. I fuck men sometimes. You know what I mean? Okay. You know what I mean? Like it's not, but it's the dudes that are not that, maybe a little insecure about, am I a man? You know, comparing themselves to those guys that like, they get a little, is this gay? Is this not gay? That's just my experience. But I've just kind of not like ever cared. I mean, I've had countless, I mean, when people find out you're in porn, at least for me, like my Facebook, if I get a Facebook message, 100%, it's someone I went to high school with or I knew before I was in porn, and they have a sex question. You know what I mean? Everyone else DMs me on Twitter or texts me or something like that. You know, but a Facebook message, that's that. And I get regular messages of people questioning their sexuality. Like I do a lot of pegging. So like a lot of guys, like I want to get pegged, but I don't know if that makes me gay and you know. And it doesn't logically makes no sense because time is a thing. Like if I sucked a dick last week, I guess that was a gay thing. So in that moment, I was doing a gay thing. But then a week later, my wife's walking through the house in leggings, and I'm like, oh my God, she's so hot. That's a straight thing, you know? Mm-hmm. How do you? The thing I did last week has no effect on the thing the next week. I don't know if I'm making sense with that, but it doesn't, you know, in the moment, you can't, what you did in the past doesn't affect your sexuality now.
Yeah, I guess it's like, yeah, I mean, I guess it's our obsession with, it just comes down to like labeling ourselves and our obsession with labeling ourselves and our obsession with being like, you know, what box do we fit in? Are we gay? Right. Are we straight? Are we bi? And could one experience identify our sexuality for the rest of our life? And could we ever get past that? Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, make sure that you subscribe so you don't miss a single episode. And go check out all the other videos. I film every single one of my podcasts. And if you want to listen to the audio version, I'm on iTunes and all the other podcast platforms. Visit hollyrandallunfiltered.com to find out more.